In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware free worksheet under the Infinite Algebra 2 section. You can find this within the Equations and Inequalities subsection, and this worksheet is Compound Inequalities. So for Compound Inequalities, we're going to have and we're going to have OR. So we're going to have one inequality and another inequality, or we're going to have one inequality or another inequality. So think of this as a Venn diagram. Here's and here's the diagram for OR. And is going to be that intersection. So this is one inequality on this side. Here's the other inequality on this side. And that intersection we can think of as and. For OR, we have one inequality represented by the left circle, the other inequality represented by the right circle. And when we're combining those inequalities with OR, we are looking at the union. So that is everything shaded in, both the intersection and each inequality. So let's look at number one. In number one, we have n plus 1 is less than or equal to negative 3, or negative 4n is less than negative 8. What we're going to do is solve each of those, and since it's OR, we're going to graph the union. So for n plus 1 less than or equal to negative 3, we're going to subtract 1 from both sides to get that n is less than or equal to negative 3 minus 1, which is negative 4. So let's go ahead and graph that. N is less than or equal to negative 4, circle negative 4, shaded in, and n is everything less than or equal to, so we're shading to the left. Now, let's solve for negative 4n is less than negative 8. Divide both sides by negative 4 to get that n is, we're going to have to flip the inequality sign since we divided by a negative, so n is greater than positive 2. Now let's graph that. Circle the 2 and then shade everything to the right. Now we've graphed both inequalities. N is less than or equal to negative 4, or n is greater than 2. Let's look at number 2. In number 2, we have k over 4 is greater than or equal to 1, or k divided by 3 is less than or equal to negative 1. Again, we're combining those with OR, so it's going to be the union, so everything that these inequalities represent. For k divided by 4 is greater than or equal to 1, we're going to multiply both sides by 4 to get that k is greater than or equal to 4. For k divided by 3 is less than or equal to negative 1, we're going to multiply both sides by 3 to get that k is less than or equal to negative 3. So we have k is greater than or equal to 4, or k is less than or equal to negative 3. Graphing the first one, k is greater than or equal to 4, circle 4, fill that in and shade everything to the right. And then k is less than or equal to negative 3, we're going to circle negative 3, fill that in and shade everything to the left. So since this is an OR compound inequality, we can choose any of the numbers that we've shaded in, and only one of these inequalities has to be true. However, if this was an AND inequality, the value we choose for k would need to be true for both. Hence, why OR is the union and is the intersection. So number 3, we have our first AND compound inequality. We have 2 is less than 2x, and 2x is less than 6. So let's go ahead and solve each of these, and then we're going to graph the intersection. So I'm going to divide both sides by 2, and my 2 is less than 2x inequality to get that 1 is less than x, and I'm going to divide both sides by 2 in this inequality to get that x is less than 3. So I have that 1 is less than x, and x is less than 3. So x has to be greater than 1, and it also has to be less than 3. So we're going to circle the 1, circle the 3, and shade in everything in between, the intersection of each of these inequalities. If we wanted to, we could have also left this as 2 is less than 2x, which is less than 6, and solve by dividing both the left, middle, and right sides by 2 to get 1 is less than x, which is less than 3. 1 is less than x and x is less than 3 is the same as 1 is less than x, which is less than 3. So if you feel more comfortable splitting up the inequality, feel free to do that, or you can leave it together. Just remember, whatever you do to one side, you must do to the middle and the other side. So number 4, we have 6 is less than or equal to x plus 6, and x plus 6 is less than or equal to 11. So let's go ahead and solve for this without breaking it up. I'm going to start by subtracting 6. I'm going to subtract 6 from the middle, 6 from the left, and 6 from the right. 6 minus 6 is 0, so I'll have 0 is less than or equal to x plus 6 minus 6, which is simply x, which is less than or equal to 11 minus 6, which is 5. So my new and compound inequality, because remember, this is an and problem, since 6 is less than or equal to x plus 6 and x plus 6 is less than or equal to 11, I have 0 is less than or equal to x, which is less than or equal to 5. So I'm going to circle and shade in my 0. I'm going to circle, fill in the 5, and shade in everything in between. 0 is less than or equal to x, which is less than or equal to 5. Let's move on to number 5. In number 5, I have negative 3 is less than m minus 5, which is less than negative 1. So again, I have an and compound inequality, so I'm going to be doing the intersection. I'm going to start by adding 5 to the middle, to the left, and to the right. Negative 3 plus 5 is a positive 2. That is less than m, since m minus 5 plus 5 is m plus 0, which is m, and that is less than negative 1 plus 5, which is a positive 4. So when I graph this, 2 is less than m, which is less than 4. I'm going to circle the 2, circle the 4, and shade in everything in between. I have an or compound inequality, so I'm going to be doing the union. For p plus 4 is less than or equal to 1, I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides to get that p is less than or equal to negative 3. For p minus 1 is greater than or equal to 1, I'm going to add 1 to both sides to get that p is greater than or equal to 2. So I have p is less than or equal to negative 3, or p is greater than or equal to positive 2. So I'm going to circle the negative 3, fill that in, and shade everything to the left. And I'm going to circle the positive 2, fill that in, and shade everything to the right. So picking any number within the shaded region will be true for at least one of these inequalities. In number 7, I have an and compound inequality. I'm going to start by adding 12 to the middle, and whatever I do to the middle, I have to do to the left and to the right. Negative 33 plus 12 is going to give me negative 21, and that's less than or equal to negative 7n, which is less than negative 26 plus 12, which is a negative 14. Then I'm going to divide everything by negative 7. However, remember, since I'm dividing by a negative, I'm switching the inequality signs. So this is now going to be negative 21 divided by negative 7, which is a positive 3, is greater than or equal to n, which is greater than negative 14 divided by negative 7, which is a positive 2. And we could rewrite this in a different order as 2 is less than n, which is less than or equal to positive 3. So I'm going to circle the 2, circle the 3, fill in that circled 3, and shade in everything in between. Now on to number 8, where again, we have an or compound inequality, so we're looking at the union of the two. In the first inequality, I'm going to start by subtracting 9 from both sides. I'll get that 2b is less than negative 2. When I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that b is less than negative 1. For the second inequality, I'll start by subtracting 7 from both sides. In doing this, I'll get that negative 5b is less than negative 15, since negative 8 minus 7 is negative 15. Then I'll divide both sides by negative 5 to get that b is, switching the inequality sign since I divided by a negative, greater than positive 3. So I have b is less than negative 1, or b is greater than 3. So I'm going to circle negative 1, shade in everything to the left, and I'm going to circle 3 and shade everything to the right. And that's my answer, and number 8. Please remember to give me a thumbs up on this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also, if you have any questions, feel free to go to my tutorial section on YouTube or leave it in the comment section below. Join me in the next video where I'll work through numbers 9 through 14.